No Small Matter, Science on the Nanoscale, is a book that George Whitesides and I started probably it was about 5 years ago. We had this idea that it was pretty important to somehow convey what in the world is going on at such a small scale, because science is very, very different at that scale. We knew that we wanted to create a series of metaphors to describe these very difficult concepts. This is not a picture of nanoscience. This is a picture that's trying to represent something about nanoscience. One of the ideas that I had was to try to show the counterintuitiveness of quantum mechanics. The problem with quantum mechanics is that it is not about physicality. It's about probability. And things can be one thing and at the same time be another. So I decided, why not make a picture that cannot be? That it just you look at it and you say, wait a second, this is counterintuitive. So I started off with a picture that I made of the Salk Institute. So I added to that image an image that I made of the Hagasphere. The problem was that too many people liked it, and so I scratched that and started it all over again and began with an apple, a glass apple. And so what I decided to do was to add to the image a shadow that was square, which is impossible to be for real. If you really think about it, things have the ability to be two things at the same time. The image that I made with those pins, I don't know if your viewers are familiar with that toy that has hundreds of pins, and if you put your hand in it, for example, the pins will take on the shape of your hand. Well, that, in effect, is the way an atomic force microscope works. It literally feels the surface of very small things. It senses what is going on at the surface, and you in fact get to see what is going on by the configuration of the pins. And that was our metaphor of trying to show how an atomic force microscope works. The way we worked was that occasionally I would suggest an idea for for the book, and then George would suggest another idea. He came up with the idea of showing a drop of water, because if you think about it, a drop is, why does a drop hold its shape? What's going on there? Well, what's going on there is nanoscience, that there's literally a molecular skin holding that drop in place until, of course, it eventually falls. We decided to include a picture of fog because there are a number of people are very concerned about what they consider the dangers of nanotechnology. But the idea in that was to show that nanoscience is all around us all the time.